Hey guys, it's me, Stormy, and here's your weekly horoscope for the week of May 7th. And this week we have also got a Mother's Day giveaway with you. I'm doing a beautiful collaboration with an absolutely extraordinary crystal healer. So this week you've got the opportunity to go over, like our Instagram pages, pull a little message up, let us know that you're interested for your chance to win one of 10 of her absolutely gorgeous gemstone chakra balancing bracelets for mom, for you, for whoever you want to give it to. And not only that, we're going to include a consultation with her to find out which bracelet is probably best for you, but in the end you get to choose. So you are interested in winning that, all you've got to do is go over, like, the Instagrams. All the details are in the description box down below, as well as a link to her website so you can check out her gorgeous jewelry. So what a beautiful Mother's Day thing. Now we've got a busy week up in the sky, by the way. We have got a sign change happening for Mercury. We've got Venus doing some action with Neptune. A little bit of conflict during the week. The sun's also moving on and being steady right here in Taurus. So this is a beautiful energy. So let's start right here on Monday. So Monday could actually be very, very interesting. So this is May 7th. We've got Mercury and Pluto in a square here. So when Mercury and Pluto are in a square, first of all, we could have some secretive things going on, right? Like conversation, thinking, actions could be a little bit secretive. This is also an energy I think is important to watch out for anything manipulative. But what I do think it's beautiful for is having deep conversation, right? Deep conversation, deep thought. If you're studying, trying to finish up that degree right now, or working on a project or something like that, the depth of thought here I think is actually really, really beautiful. Now later the exact same day, we've got Venus and Neptune in a square. Now the Bopsy twins, whenever they get together, information gets a little fuzzy. It really does. Feels good, but it gets a little fuzzy. So I do, again, next to that Mercury and Pluto energy, think you have to watch out for information not being clear, information not being exactly honest or above board. You'll want to pay attention to that, okay? Especially because Venus is a financial planet and a romantic planet. Be mindful of either one of those spaces in your world, okay? Now, on Tuesday the 8th, we've got the Sun actually coming into its annual opposition with Jupiter, which is interesting because we've got Jupiter, who's our biggest benefic planet, right? He's kind of tagging on opposition here to Sun, who's even bigger than him, so this is vitality. We're wanting to expand, and we want to be vital, but they're in oppositions here. So one of the things I'm thinking of in this energy is you're really trying to push something forward. You're really trying to do something and you are just so optimistic about it, right? You think your light is just going to shine so bright here, but you have to be mindful not to be overestimating what you're doing, overexciting what you're doing, right? Be excited, be conscious, be present, but pay attention to letting your pride get in the way, being overenthusiastic about it, or putting too much. You know what I mean? If you want to make the perfect recipe, you got to put the right amount of spices. You don't need the extra. So pay attention to that, okay? Now, I do think it's interesting that we have a really nice trine happening Friday, May 11th here. We've actually got the Sun, who's over here in Taurus, nice, steady, sturdy, in a trine with Pluto. Wonderful energy for being productive, for getting things done. The other thing I think of with the Sun here being so sturdy and steady, and Pluto being this place of depth, is that you could have things manifesting here. Maybe some things you've been working on, or maybe that big project you were working on earlier in the week that you got too hype about actually starts to take some physical form here. This would be a beautiful way to be ushering in Mother's Day, don't you think? Especially because on Sunday the 13th, which is Mother's Day, we've got Uranus and Mercury in a conjunction. These two in a conjunction here, first of all, bring out very surprising conversation, very surprising thinking. It can make you very nervous because these are both very electric energies. But one of the things I think about, especially with the Sun over here in Taurus and then Mercury moving over here into Taurus as well, is that conversation and your words and your thinking, they're more intuitive, they're more intentional, right? You're conscious of what you're saying. Maybe you're even having an awakening or an opening or a new thought process around some things that are going on in your world, especially wouldn't it be great to, regardless of what your relationship is with your mother or that mothering energy or you as a mother, wouldn't it be wonderful to let in some new perspective, some new healing, some new enthusiasm, right? A new perspective on all things momming would be absolutely brilliant to let in this week. So I think it's going to be an interesting energy when Mercury is in Taurus. We do tend to speak more slowly, more intensely, more deliberately. So I think it'll be a great week, you guys, especially because there's a giveaway and it's free. All you got to do is like the Instagram pages, okay? Come like us. The stuff is in the description box down below. Check out these beautiful gemstone chakra balancing bracelets and get hooked up so you can get yours, all right? Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. Keep me posted on how your week goes. Whatever your relationship is with your mom, I am sending you a lot of light, a lot of love, a lot of beauty for your week, okay? Bye, guys.